Isaac, Isaac, can you maybe get that leg out?
Because I put my pants. Yeah, and then it happened again in fifth grade.
You guys
sixth grade. Seventh grade.
This way. Good. A little closer. There you go. Good. Okay, good.
Because I'm a lady.
Yes.
Well, you never know.
Okay, I'm done.
Me too. Everybody go home. Thank you so much.
Okay, but now let's do that on the steps so you get some pretty backlight.
All over. Actually, I just did a gig in Long Island, but like birthdays, festivals, and libraries.
Watch your step.
July 27th, and then in the morning, and that evening, it's all
that's all I need.
Well, Isaac is here.
Chest or hit somebody else.
Gavin, look here, man. Look next to them.
Right.
Alec, oh, look here. Right, give me a smile right here. Thank you.
There you go. There you go. Yeah, more tree than nine.
Good.
Yeah. My place or yours?
Yeah.
All right, okay.
Close.
Next to the hub.
Through the whole thing?
Thank you.
There's just a pool a little bit in your area. Yeah, that's good. Cool.
Baruch haba b'shem Adonai, beirachnuchem mi beit Adonai. מיידיר על הכל, מברוך על הכל, מגדול על הכל. יברך החתן והכלה. We welcome you, Isaac and Marina. In this moment, your hopes and your dreams are being fulfilled. Today is a merging of two paths of life into one. Bruchim habayim. We welcome you to a loving partnership, and we offer our blessings upon the bride and the groom.
Okay, I forgot to print out my introduction, so bear with the laptop. And welcome to the tree. I'd like to thank everyone for being here. Some of you traveled great distances from Denmark, Germany, and performed feats of scheduling gymnastics, like stopping here on the way home from Africa, braved the indignities of airport security, and all of you from the great state of New Jersey who bravely traversed the Cross Bronx Expressway to be here with Isaac and Marina. We're so glad you all could make it. Today we mark the beginning of Isaac and Marina's life together as a married couple, and to celebrate the wonderful relationship that brought us to this moment. It began when Isaac had enough with New York City and all of its noisy mayhem and moved out to Ithaca at the behest of his friend Matt and Matt's partner Lily, who introduced him to her sister, Marina. Marina was living in the communal eco-house known as the Dacha, which she and Lily had built with some friends. Within a miraculously short few months, Isaac and Marina were an item. Within a year, Isaac made the decision to move in. Clearly, it was the right choice for both of them because here we are. Last week, they had their first wedding ceremony on their property in Freeville, New York. It was officiated by Lily operating a giant puppet and included audience participation, Matt falling into a pond, and Isaac's trusty pair of Tevas. Today, we're going to keep things slightly more conventional, but to all of us who know Isaac or Marina, we can appreciate that the kind of people who would envision such an event to mark their commitment to one another are lucky to have found each other. Throughout the past several years, they have already begun the process of intertwining their lives, forming a symbolic relationship, a symbiotic relationship, becoming a binary system, creating a life together throughout which their happiness, creativity, and affection for one another will mature into something more complex and nuanced with every trial, every accomplishment, every new experience, and with each passing day. Now, let's take a moment to remember those who are no longer with us. Marina's grandparents, Frina, Dima, Bella, and Grisha, Isaac's grandpa Robert Sharp, and most recently Isaac's grandpa Harry Friedman, and Marina's aunt Anya. Even though Harry is not here today, I know it means a lot to so many of us here that Harry got a chance to meet Marina and Marina Harry. If you hadn't, I feel your introduction to this family would have been incomplete. In honor of Grandpa, I'd like to call up our sister Adrian to sing a song. And Jordan.
Because I'm nervous and I don't want to forget you.
It's very clear.
How blessed we are to witness this day of holiness for Isaac and Marina. And we rejoice that these beloveds have found one another. It is as if all moments have been leading to this one very special moment under this chuppah, surrounded by the love of family and friends. We should mention at this time that this chuppah, the fabric itself, is a fabric from Marina's grandmother, and it was very lovingly embroidered by Julie Sharp over the course of the past weeks, and here it is, and it takes on a special added resonance as it is your wedding canopy. I'm going to hand you a Kiddush cup at this time, and Isaac, if you would hold on to that, you both can hold it together. That's a good way to do it. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam v'rei pri hagafen. You may take a seat. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'hitir lanu et hanesuim v'hanesuot lanu al yedei chuppah v'kiddushin. Baruch ata Adonai megadeish amo Yisrael al yedei chupa vekidushin.
Next, Isaac and Marina have written their own vows that they are going to share with us today.
Song first?
Yeah.
Who goes first?
I think we're going to do the song
after.
The song right now.
Song right now?
Okay.
Song.
Good.
Song. Okay. Hey. So we have a song that is part of Isaac's vows.
No, it can go.
Okay.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Sure.
We're not too uptight right now.
Yeah.
Oh, no. We don't need that. Yeah, we'll be fine. This is for you. So Isaac asked me to write a piece sort of as a reflection of his meeting and marrying Marina. So we talked about having some music that felt simple and calm and meditative, but that wouldn't really be 100% right because there were some complicated emotions and choices and life events that led to this moment, that led to Isaac and Marina meeting each other and falling in love. So this was written with all that in mind, and as an ode to the two of you and to your senses.
Ooh.
Those who say that a wordless melody is really the sincerest form of prayer. There are no words to get in the way. And that was quite lovely. Isaac, Marina, before you speak the formal vows that will unite your lives, we know that you have composed words for each other for this special moment. Can we give you the mic?
Sure. From an email dated August 24th, 2014. Don't worry, things are not now weird. Well, weirder. I enjoyed last night as well. It is what it is. And whatever that is exactly, time will tell. In any case, a good experience. That was sent the morning after our first date. Shortly thereafter, Marina, I told you that I was treating our relationship like an experiment. Rather than being taken aback, though, you immediately understood what I meant. Of course, we agreed, only through experimentation can one hope to improve upon things in a rational way. And what could be better than that? So we, each simultaneously experimenter and test subject, embarked on this experiment in life sharing. This experimental mindset is one of the most important characteristics that I think we share. We take each day to be the unique opportunity that it is and learn what we can from it. We make few assumptions, take little for granted, and go out of our way to experience new things. As with any good experiment, though, parameters must be set. Some baseline expectation against which variables can be measured. So here are some expectations I have for myself. I promise, a word you and I don't use lightly, that to the best of my ability, I will remain interesting. To challenge you with new ideas, to recommend good books, to point out plants and animals, to do strange and spontaneous things, to make art. I promise to be open-minded, to always consider the possibility that I am completely wrong.
No.
To never argue for the sake of arguing. To take criticism constructively. Even the criticism that I am not taking criticism constructively. You might have to remind me. I promise to be caring and attentive, to become ever increasingly aware of your needs and desires, to bring you water just before you're thirsty, to know when you'd like a massage or when you'd like to be left alone to read or think, to listen thoughtfully. I'm in awe of the inconceivable uncertainty of life and humbly acknowledge the extraordinary good fortune I've experienced. But not everything can be reduced simply to chance. Unless, of course, you're of the reasonable opinion that even the thoughts in our minds are simply the result of the great subatomic game of dominoes. But that aside, The undeniable fact is that today, I'm a much happier person than I was on August 24th, 2014. And I like to think that we're doing something right. I look forward to our future together, to all the plans we make and bring to fruition, and to all the surprises we adapt to. Good luck to us.
Beautiful.
That's really beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's almost like I wrote it. In honor of your love of trees and our tradition of planting a new tree for each year that we celebrate together, here is a poem. Two trees near to each other stood when they were young and life was new. Their limbs reach out and their branches intertwine, and thus together they grew. Their roots spread out under the ground, joining with one another. So from the top of the sky to the bottom heart of the earth, the two were joined together. Through days when the sun was bright and warm, and the winds were temperamental, when a laughing breeze rustled the leaves, or when the rain was soft and gentle. Through days when the clouds were dark and gray, and cold and fierce the weather, the two stood firm and faced the storm because they stood together. I hope that we grow together like trees, and that our roots are deeply intertwined underground, so that when all the pretty blossoms of the trees fall and leave the branches bare and naked on top, we will still be connected by those roots, and that we have been growing for so long that our tree can blossom again. So for you, I promise a word we do rarely use. I promise to be patient with you. I promise to be compassionate and kind. I promise to respect your decisions, even if it's to wear sweatpants when we go out. I promise to always be grateful and to let you know that you are loved. I promise to always be there for you like you have been there for me, especially when I'm thirsty. Love is an art and a fortunate accident, and I'm glad we came upon it together.
Thank you. Okay, guys, now in just a moment, well, first and foremost, I have a pretty important question to ask of you both. Mm-hmm. This isn't part of the Jewish wedding ritual, but it is very much a part of Americana and wedding practice, and I would be remiss if I didn't ask you, do you, Isaac, take Marina to be your partner in life, to love, to honor, and to cherish?
Yes, I do.
And do you, Marina, take Isaac to be your partner in life, to love, to honor, and to cherish?
I do.
I'm going to ask Isaac, if you would take Marina's ring, and what you can do is, you can just cue it up, if you would place that on her index finger, not the ring finger just yet, just kind of put it lightly.
Uh-huh.
You
mm-hmm.
got it. Yes. So, as you place this ring upon Marina's index finger, would you recite these words that will formally unite you in marriage? And I'll take you through it one word at a time. Hare.
Hare.
Hat.
Hat.
At.
At.
Mikudeshet.
Mikudeshet.
Li.
Li.
Vitaba'at.
Vitaba'at.
Zo.
Zo.
Kedat.
Kedat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
Be consecrated to me.
Be consecrated to me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my partner.
As my partner.
In keeping with the heritage of our tradition.
In keeping with the heritage of our tradition.
And you may move that ring to Marina's ring finger. And Marina, if you would respond in kind, they want to hear you, they don't want to hear me. Okay.
if you would place that, yeah, you got it on Isaac's ring finger, index finger, and we'll move it in just a moment. If you would recite these words, Hare.
Hare.
Atah.
Atah.
Mikudash.
Mikudash.
Li.
Li.
Vitabaat.
Vitabaat.
Zo.
Zo.
Kedat.
Kedat.
Moshe.
Moshe.
V'Yisrael.
V'Yisrael.
Be consecrated to me.
Be consecrated to me.
With this ring.
With this ring.
As my partner.
As my partner.
In keeping with the heritage of our tradition.
In keeping with the heritage of our tradition.
And you may move that ring to Isaac's ring finger. You got the right one. Okay. Baruch atah Adonai mekadesh amo Yisrael al yedei chupa v'kidushin. We are so blessed to celebrate this moment with you both. And seven blessings?
Seven blessings.
Okay, well, I will clue in everybody who is in attendance. Now, I may be the rabbi come lately, but I do know that you guys are a bit unconventional, and that's a beautiful thing. I want to say that. This is the first time I have ever officiated a wedding under a canopy of trees, and it is just spectacularly beautiful. I know the weather reports leading up to today were heart attack inducing, but you know what? Look at today. Today is spectacular, and I think that's a sign. You know, in a minute we're going to say Mazel Tov, in a minute, not just yet. But Mazel Tov, the words, we tend to, they have the connotation of congratulations, hey, let's have a party. Mazel Tov, the words themselves, they literally mean a good star, as in a good star is shining down upon you both on this beautiful day. So we're going to heap blessings upon you with the seven blessings, and then we'll have a chance to say Mazel Tov at the end. I'm going to give you one more chance to have a sip of wine. You may both hold that. It'll be a moment or two, so, you know, work up your strength there, okay? Yeah, you got it. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam borei pri hagafen.
May you be inspired each day by the abundance of the natural world, by science and technology, as well as art, music, literature, and creative expression.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam shehakol bara lichvodo.
People have the capacity for love and friendship, generosity, kindness, and compassion. May you express these qualities freely and be blessed to receive them throughout your lives.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam yotzer haadam.
The diversity of humanity is remarkable. Out of the same basic shape, infinite variations. May you find comfort in the similarities shared by all of the world's cultures and celebrate the qualities which make each of us different.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher yatzar et ha'adam b'tzalmo b'tzelem demut avnito v'hitkin lo mimenu binyan adei ad. Baruch atah Adonai Yotzer Adam.
Despite its joys, we live in a broken world. May you be blessed to live in a world where there is food for those who are hungry, homes for those who are homeless, freedom for those who are oppressed, and peace and equality for all.
So tasis v'tagel ha'akara b'kibbutz b'neha l'tocha b'simcha baruch atah Adonai v'sameach tzion b'vaneha.
Today we celebrate this couple as they freely unite. May you live in a world where this freedom is extended to all people, allowing anyone to marry without judgment, impediment, or persecution.
Sameach tesamach re'im ha'ahuvim, kesamechacha yetzircha, v'gan eden mikedem, baruch atah Adonai, mesameach chatan v'kala.
With the breaking of the glass, today's ceremony will end and celebration will begin. As we shout Mazel Tov, let us wish good luck for this couple and make this wish to ourselves and our loved ones. May every day be full of happiness, love, friendship, harmony, laughter, and rejoicing.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher bara sasson v'simcha chatan v'chala Asher bara sasson v'simcha chatan v'chala Gila rina dihitza v'chedva Achava v'achava v'shalom v'reyut Gila rina dihitza v'chedva Achava v'achava v'shalom v'reyut Meheira Adonai Eloheinu Yishama v'reyuhuda v'chutso Yerushalayim Kol ha-sason ve-kol simcha Kol chatan ve-kol kala Kol ha-sason ve-kol simcha Kol chatan ve-kol kala Kol mitzalot chatanim mechupatam Unearim mimishte niginatam Baruch atah Adonai Mesameach chatan Yim hakala
Okay. Tough to follow. The ritual of drinking wine at Jewish celebrations is an expression of joy and sanctification. May you find something to celebrate every day of your life, and may your cup runneth over.
You can take another sip. Why not? I will take that from you. And in just a moment, we can place that next to Isaac's foot, but don't do it just yet. Now, as you have both shared the wine from a single cup, so may you share contentment, peace, and fulfillment from the cup of life. May you find life's joys heightened, its bitterness sweetened, and each of its moments hallowed by true companionship and love. Now, we gave the clue into all these wonderful people that those words are going to say after they hear that pop. Those words are Mazel Tov, okay? So when you hear the pop, you can just let it fly. But before you do, Isaac and Marina, I think it's only fair that maybe you both share this ritual. As you both break this glass, so may you dispel any tribulation or doubt which for a fragile or fleeting moment may come to touch you. May your love last as long as it would take to reassemble this broken glass to wholeness again. As this glass is broken forever, so may your love endure forever and ever. For it is a sign, an emblem of your everlasting love. Now, you're going to have to be very careful to not get right on top of each other, but why not together? What do you think? Count of three.
All right.
You guys do it.
I'm going to take this.
Your
turn.
Okay.
You got a good stomp.
Away?
Yeah.
Let's get out of here.
Mark! Hey. I don't want to hug you.
I don't know where she's supposed to go. Do you know where the photo ops are?
The photo ops?
photo ops were by the stairs where we did the other stuff. In front of the statue.
Okay.
That's my friend Mark.
Nice.
Guys, how do you feel?
Like a whole new thing.
It's so different.
So different than last week.
It was a little different.
I really liked Adrian's song.
Yeah?
Yeah, that was beautiful.
Beautifully said, you guys.
Oh.
You really nailed it with the thing.
Yeah?
You did better this time than me, I think.
You wrote that poem.
No, I didn't. I stole it.
Really? Yeah. It's a nice poem.
Thank you.
Who wrote it?
I don't know. Captain Mendeley? I don't know.
All right.
You really nailed it, though.
Oh,
I can't believe you read that about our boniversary.
You like that?
Yeah, you're so bad. You pulled a Matt.
Yeah, but it was a little more subtle than a true Matt.
It wasn't that subtle, I'll be honest with you. All right, all the food is mine. Send the guests home. Just kidding, what? And the people who are working really hard to make it happen can eat with us.
Look at that.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, thanks. It was really fun.
Let's just take one of these on our way.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
I just want to make sure I got this.
No, we're going to be there for a number of years.
Nice to meet you.
I think so.
You can take a whole glass.
This is the easy part.
No. I know.
Now I can just enjoy.
Excuse me. But you got to play music the way you want.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, he's the father. Come on, I'm nobody.
That's what it is.
Please don't do that.
Yes, we will. We will. I promise.
Here we go. Eyes here.
All right.
Here we go. Look here. Okay. Mom, move your hair's in the way. Move this way. Dad, move this way. Thank you. Okay.
Okay, next, you've got Isaac Marina with Marina's family. We did that. Yeah. So, Ted, the photo I want is the five of us with Marietta and the five of us. Thank you. Marietta.
Come on, this is the real thing. All right, guys.
All right, now we can look cool.
And then there will be various points that people will come and say.
Go! Winning! Woo!
Okay.
Is that over?
I'm going to be in this picture. So
Ella?
Brust raus.
Hold on. Chest. I can't shoot that fast because the lights have been back. All right, here we go.
Hold this out.
Okay. Nice smile. Down.
Okay. Josh, say something funny. Not that funny.
Can you Photoshop me?
Julie, only for you would I do this. Here we go, guys. Nice smile.
Cocktails.
Thank you.
I shouldn't have said anything. I'm sorry. They went fast. One left and they came over and I let Alex have it. Obviously, I'm
a state.
Cousins.
Nice smile.
Okay, we only have 25 smiles.
Thank you.
Thank you.
No, you have to wait for Natalie.
Holtzman, Bernardoni.
Natalie!
Okay.
But I'm going to pretend I do because that's what I've been doing here. So nice to see you again. All right, you guys. Make it easy for Ted.
Eyes here.
That's his job. That's what he gets paid for.
Yeah. I want that job. Cool. You feel like my muscles? Okay, Ted, we want to take one photo of me and Isaac, but we need help getting into position. Whoa. Are you cool with that?
Is this your honeymoon?
No, I want to get on his shoulder and have my dress cover his head so his feet look like my feet.
Oh my god.
I don't know if it's going to work. Someone might get hurt. Right, I'll take your vest off.
Oh, you want stepping ladder?
I think I want. Is that okay?
Yeah.
This is not your wedding.
Stepping ladder?
Ted, when are you conventional all of a sudden? When are you following the rules all of a sudden?
Do you actually want to have you want to be on him or do you want to have stepping ladder?
I want to see if I can get on his shoulders.
Yeah, I think you can do it.
Ready?
Oh, we don't
know.
Oh,
yeah.
All right, ready? Wait, on your shoulders, babe?
Just a balancing.
You want it to be, like, covered.
Let me see his face. Medics here.
Here. It's a lot.
The tallest she's ever been.
Can I see his face? Can you? I just see his head.
That would be so inappropriate.
No, you got to do it.
Oh, this is too funny. This is really too funny.
Oh, my God. This is beautiful.
Hey. It's so beautiful.
Now you gotta say, where's Isaac?
Lily.
Where's my husband?
Lily.
Has anyone seen my husband? Can you pretend you're running?
Oh, God.
Can you breathe, honey?
Slightly.
Can you breathe?
Well, I'd like to see
a birthing.
Vertically.
Okay.
I don't know if this is appropriate.
All right, we're coming down.
Okay, coming down.
All right.
Woo! Thanks, I really wanted to do
that. That was great.
That's the best example I've ever seen of like a bride really singing.
Let me just tie one thing.
Okay.
Before you take a look. It looks like I'm birthing you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to ask everybody to please rise from your chairs and please put your hands together for our newlyweds as we invite them to the dance floor. Put your hands together for Isaac and Marina, everyone. You could do better than that. Come on, Isaac and Marina, come on. First dance is husband and wife.
Instead of landing on Plymouth Rock, Plymouth Rock would land on.
Isaac and Marina. Incredible job. Dancing with the Stars material right there. We're going to ask Marina now to please escort her dad out to the middle of the dance floor. Can we please put your hands together for Marina and her very, very handsome dad? All family and friends to please join Marina and her dad on the dance floor. That means everybody here, please, come on, join us for a beautiful song. For Marina and her dad. We're going to ask everybody to stay right where you are. We could not start a celebration without this song. It is time to celebrate with Isaac and Marina. Time time to do a horror. So let us get all everybody up on this dance floor. We need a big circle on this dance floor. Everybody grab hands. We all love each other in here. So don't be shy. We can form a circle inside the circle. Also, since we have a lot of people, well, let's start turning the circle to the left. Here we go. Turn that circle to the left. Stop. Let's go the other way. Other way. Whatever time you go, let's go the other way. Turn that circle other way. Other way. And stop. Turn it back the other way. Other way. Stop where you are. Put your hands in the air. Clap your hands. Clap your hands. We're going to try to get to the middle of this circle. I'm skinny. I can make it. All right. Where is Marina? Marina, you first. Let's get Marina right here. Find another chair. Everybody grab hands, turn those circles while we find another chair. Here they come, here they come, here they come. All right, Steve to the rescue, Steve to the rescue. Here we come. Let's get Green in that chair. I need some strong gentlemen right there on the count of three, gentlemen. One, two, three, and everybody make some noise. Come on, Green, let's go. Everybody sing. Isaac, it is your turn. Let's get some strong gentlemen in there for Isaac. Here we go on the count of three. One, two, three. Everybody make some noise for Isaac. Same time. We have to have them both at the same time, Marina. Just for about 15 seconds, we need the both of them up in the air. So we can see how handsome and beautiful they are. All right, everybody, get ready. Here we go. We count to three. One, two, three. Make some noise for Isaac and Marina. We'll be right back. Now here's what I need everybody to do. I need to get rid of those two chairs first and foremost, but I want everybody to grab a partner. Find a partner right there on the dance floor, and as you do, I want you to grab them by the arm, and we're going to do a little do-si going. Come on. Grab your partner, spin them around. Spin that partner around and around. Here we go. Person to your right. Just look to the person. If you do not know them, I want you to introduce yourself. Say, hello, my name is, how are you? Nice to meet you. And I want you to grab them by the arm and start spinning them around. Come on, we love each other in the room. It's all about the love. Spin them person round and round. Switch those arms. Let's go. Come on. Swing it if you know it. Stop where they are, and I want a bunch of small circles, 5-6 people. Just grab who's ever around you, small circles all through the dance floor, and let's start turning those circles to the left. Start turning those circles to the left, left, left. And stop to the right, right, right. Circles in the middle, and you're going to scream as loud as you can. Here we go. 1, 2, 3 in the middle, and scream. And one more time. 1, 2, 3, and scream. Let's get one big circle. One more time. One big circle. And what I need is I need Marina and her dad. And I need Isaac and mom. Right in the middle. Right in the middle. Everybody on the outside, clap those hands. Come on, I want to see all those hands clapping for the family. Alright, let's get Steve with Marina. Steve with Marina. And let's get Marina's mom with Isaac in there. Come on. Sisters and brothers, sisters and brothers, please join right on in. Sisters and brothers, let's go. On the count of three, ladies and gentlemen, what we are going to do is we are going to give Isaac and Marina the most incredible group hug we have ever given anybody in our lives. So on the count of three, I want everybody in the middle to give them a hug. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Everybody in the middle, and give them a great big group hug. Great job. Give yourselves a great big round of applause, everybody. That was a great, wonderful job. We're going to ask everybody to find their seats once again. Ladies and gentlemen, if we may have everybody's attention at this time, we are going to pass the microphone over to our best man, Alec, for our champagne toast. Can we please have a big round of applause for Alec, everyone?
Thank you. All right.
Well. Alec.
Hi, everybody. I'm Alec, and I'll like to start by just getting the credentials out of the way as soon as possible. I've known Isaac since before Tales of the Far Side was released on VHS in 1994. This way.
Hey.
Which is, of course, the year after Bubsy Claws Encounters of the Furred Kind was released for Sega Genesis in 1993. Two obviously seminal moments in the childhood that Isaac and I shared. You might think that it's literally impossible for us to have been present at each other's births, but if you're saying that, you just probably just don't understand the depth of the bond that we have with each other. So I hope this speech will at least give you a sense of that. But the point of establishing that is just to say, I hope with some credibility, that we have some things in common that have helped me think about how you have arrived at this moment and how great of a fit you and Marina are for each other. So to establish a theme here and to illustrate one of the things that I particularly relate to about Isaac's perspective on life, I want to show you all the shirt that I'm wearing. And you'll just have to give me a moment. Obviously, the part of this is to make Isaac as uncomfortable as possible. So. So this shirt that I'm wearing, it was a gift from Isaac to me a few years ago. And you can't really see what it is amidst all the confusion here, but that's sort of the point. The text here is, I think about thinking too much, too much. Which is a poem that Isaac wrote, and I think is sort of his origin story in a nutshell. If one had met Isaac, I think in the last few years, like in the New York period as it goes, but not gotten to know him terribly well, I think it'd be tempting for somebody to read you as some sort of like classic intimidating misanthrope. And to that point, I just want to recite another poem of his that I think is actually about empathy and unintentionally reveals that he's a softy, for lack of a better word, which I think is actually like an immensely important quality. But anyway, I try to be what I think is a good person. It is immensely frustrating at such times as I fall into these pits of cerebral quicksand to see people who seem to make no such effort and to be accosted constantly with the consequences of their thoughtlessness. So again, it seems sort of intense, but let me take this opportunity to inform you that he went through like a really like uncommitted hilarious goth phase in like late middle school to high school, which I'm not above admitting that I like followed in an even more sheepish way by literally just like preferring black clothes for like half of a school semester. But after seeing Isaac try, you know, ska and punk and saxophone, one is forced to understand that he's just spent a lot of time listening and absorbing and reflecting and trying things without asserting his views or way of life on anyone else, rather going out of his way to avoid doing that. So it's sort of part of why I wish I could follow him around and explain to people that that he's just meeting, that there's no need to be scared of the, you know, beard and the cold stare. He's just a giant emotional sponge. It's really, Because I don't like it is a reasonable excuse. Except for those times, it's thoughtless and obtuse. Under what obligation to describe am I not what I do or don't like, but why? What life experience has shaped my opinion, and to what extent am I mass media's minion? If, post-introspection, I don't like what's found out, will I have the will to take the path of self-doubt? When Isaac and I lived together in the city and in the few years that we both lived there, but in different apartments, I think it's safe to say that I saw him retreat inward, which is totally an understandable reaction from somebody who listens and absorbs and overthinks as much as he does. It requires and exhausts a lot of energy and focus to live above B&H photo on 34th Street and to tune that out, you know, entirely when all you really want to do is put on headphones and listen to Bach for hours and practice one of the softest musical instruments in history, just the irony. And so I think it's no, you know, coincidence that his sense of empathy was tried and tested in that environment. But this is when the story turns around, because the path of self-doubt, I think, led him to make a really important decision to try a new lifestyle entirely, which seems like a decision that when a lot of people make it, they often wish they had made earlier. One of the best things that I've learned about Marina is something I heard in a speech about her last weekend, which is that she's also a very careful listener and a thorough judge of character, which Isaac is very lucky for, because again, on the surface at the time, you couldn't blame her or anybody for meeting Isaac and seeing, you know, Dr. House, but like a classical musician instead of a doctor, or like Sherlock Holmes, but like the real mystery's inside you the whole time. But with that in mind, it's really particularly admirable that self-doubt and vulnerability did not close you off and make you hate everything, but in fact made things clearer, and I think allowed you to leave yourself open and vulnerable to a little bit of chaos and a new experience in a new place and a new incredible person and partner in Marina and a set of emotions that you were too cool to deal with beforehand. So when you might have gone Walden and lived alone in the forest, you instead half decided and half lucked out in meeting somebody that would inspire you to make a new life still in the forest, but with a bunch of other wonderful people that I'm lucky to have gotten to know. So before I read one more excerpt, I just want to raise a glass and toast to Isaac and Marina. Well, that's yours. This one. Thanks. Here. Cheers. To listening, to always being open to new ideas, and to overthinking it.
Yeah!
Woo! Cheers. I love you both. The food abounds. The place is warm and free. Sharing with family, oh so many. And friends, what joy. Each crevice, a new home. Each tiny crack, a doorway to a world bountiful, unexplored. That's part of a poem about rats in the subway.
Once again, big round of applause for Alec, everyone. At this time, your dinner is being served. We have food stations all around the tent. Please come on up.
Come fly with me. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic food, jump far and far from Bay. Come on, fly with me, we'll float down on the blue. Fly with me, float down to Peru. In Mama Land, there's a one-man band, and the truth is true for you. Fly with me, we'll take off in the blue. I get you up there, where the air is rarefied. We'll just fly, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so very near. You might even hear a gang of angels here just because.
Hello, everyone. Good night, or good evening.
Hello. My name is Alex. I am a cousin from Russia. Yes. I fly in from Russia just now. Oh, such a headache. But Marina and Isaac, wherever he's off, wherever he's gone. Congratulations. As we say in Russia, yesterday you are born. Today you are married. And tomorrow you die. So, a happy wedding. Anesthesia and
everybody. I want to tell you a short story, kids. It's not about you, relax. But other people should not. It's life story about life, one part of the life about Jewish life. I don't know what happened during this 40-year trip from Ithaca to Syracuse, but in my mind, something definitely happened wrong. Because since then, Jewish life was much more close to the hell than to heaven. But life is a coin. One side is just 25 cents, other side is ego. Good side of the story, we got as a human or as a society, we got two good things, actually two. Two is one is a hope, another an ability to believe. Third one was converted to the good banking account. Hope and ability to believe. It looks like just a work, just a miracle. But again, 2,000 years, Jewish people are praying next year in Jerusalem, and suddenly, 4 years ago, it happened. Second thing, very common, it was every parent was hope and believe that their kids will live better life than they felt. And actually, it's happened too. But remember, life is a coin. Dark side, bright side. If everything's okay, if your life is beautiful, you absolutely happy, look in the mirror, look around, probably you miss something. What I want to tell to my kids, just remember, life is a coin. Bright side, dark side. Always believe bright side coming to your life. Thank you.
And now we'd like to have Stephen and Julie come on up. Our wedding planner, Julie, please put your hands together. She did a great job, everybody. Come on up, Steve.
Okay, well, for those of you who are up in Ithaca, some of this will be a little bit of a repeat, but as Alec mentioned, when Isaac lived in the city, he was about as miserable as anybody could be. He hated everything about it other than his friends. And I guess it was 3 years ago, he made the decision, and we had heard about Matt's girlfriend Lily, and I knew Matt and Lily had been down to visit, and you know, we'd heard how nice Lily was, and Isaac went, you know, finally made the decision to move. I guess he moved up there, and a few weeks later we went up and we met them all for dinner, Matt and Lily and Isaac, at a place where Matt had a gig. And then afterwards she said, oh, you have to come see the dacha. So we're okay. I had been hearing about the dacha since Matt's parents had told us about it a number of years ago. And we go to the dacha, and we're just sitting around, and it's this wonderful place where the kids all live. And about 15, 20 minutes after we get there, all the rest of the people who live there came home. And this one very vivacious person is talking and asking me all these questions about Isaac, and I'm thinking, oh, what a nice girl. And then it took me a while till I realized this was Lily's sister. And the light bulb went on, and I'm like, wouldn't that be nice? And that was my first exposure to Marina, and she was asking me all these interesting questions about Isaac, you know, and, you know, tell me a story about this, and tell me a story about that, and I thought, how nice, she's really interested in Isaac, and since that time, let's see, that was in the summer. We were up the end of October for Isaac's birthday. And at that point, we knew that Isaac was dating Marina. But Isaac was at this phase where, you know, God forbid he should show us that he was interested in Marina. And after the weekend, I said to Isaac, you know, it's okay. We're not going to assume that every girl you go out with, you're going to marry. It's okay if you're affectionate with her, you know, if you're dating her. So that was the end of October. I think it was 2 weeks later, we get the email from Isaac. By the way, I'm bringing Marina to Thanksgiving. And we're like, aha. And this was the first time Isaac had brought a date to Thanksgiving, brought a girl to Thanksgiving. And it was like a 180 degree turn. The two of them were inseparable through Thanksgiving dinner. And we said, gee, this looks pretty nice. And Marina was so comfortable with everybody in the family, and everybody was really comfortable with Marina because she is very easy to love. She is warm and friendly and interesting and interested in everybody, and we are so thrilled that they have found each other because they so bring out the best in each other. And that's all you can hope for your child, that they meet someone who does that. And we have wonderful sons-in-law. We're just so fortunate to have in our family. And Marina is our one and only daughter-in-law. And
favorite.
And very favorite. But even if she weren't the only one, we're just thrilled to have her in the family. And we wish you just a continuation of the wonderful life that you're having together.
I just wanted to clarify a little bit about what Alec said about Isaac. Alec was born in July, actually on Bastille Day. And Isaac was born on October the 25th of the same year, the same day as Emily, his twin cousin. Alec claimed to have been present at his birth. So I don't want to dispute that, but it does say something about the nature of just how far back that relationship goes. early on, for both Isaac and Adira, particularly, I established criteria for what they should be looking for in, you know, a significant relationship. And I claimed it. And the idea was that if you do it young enough, they really won't pay attention to you. You know, because whenever they get to be like 14, 15, 16, anything you say, they're not going to pay any attention to. But whenever they're like 10, 11, 12, 13, that sort of age, then you can spout these things, and the expectation is that they will not really pay attention, but they will absorb them. So there is a number of really, I think, sensible criteria. And I must say that I am really pleased that we have succeeded, Julie and I have succeeded very well. And the spouses that all of our children have chosen, and we could not be happier, and Isaac and Marina have really just continued that. And so it's really a pleasure for us to see that they have chosen so well. So I'm not sure what more that I could be more grateful for than that. But I do have a poem. Now, it's not like some of the other poems, but it's a poem that is kind of a religious poem. And we've had a little bit of religion this evening, but you can bear with just a little bit more, because I think it kind of speaks to who they are. And it also, it dates back to the Elizabethan period, and it actually was put to song by a wonderful English, and perhaps the greatest English composer, Henry Purcell. And the title of this poem is "Hear the Deities Approve." Hear the deities approve, the God of music and of love, all the talents they have lent you, all the blessings they have sent you, pleased to see what they bestow. Live and thrive so well.
And we'd like Marietta and Lily to come on up at this time. Hey, you can clap your hands for them too, it's okay.
Okay, hey, so we just want to say a little something about the bride and groom. Since you see them before you today, all dressed up and sparkly and clean, but we live with these people.
We know the truth.
That's right. And, Marina and Isaac are very complimentary to each other. Marina, my sister, has a lot of energy, and she's always got projects, and she's always on the move, you know? And she's so excited about life and about everything that sometimes she doesn't stop to check, like, that her vocabulary skills, let's just say, are unique. Like, she once said to me, "Lily, mock my words." And I've been doing it ever since.
And Isaac is much more choice with his words. He uses them more pointedly and sparingly. Isaac's also very athletic and very much into exercising to keep up his stamina so that he can match Marina's energy. But what's also just so beautiful to witness is that he finds Marina's shenanigans so very endearing. So,
well, we thought we would give you a little glimpse into what it's like at home. So we're gonna use the ancient art of puppetry, yes, to show you a short scene of what it was like at our house a week before the wedding. You begin. We present Isaac. He's lifting a rock.
Hey, babe, what are you doing?
Exercising. Okay, yeah, that's really good. But after you do that, can you call your mom about the caterer? And we also have to mow the lawn. You really have to mow the lawn because there's gonna be 120 people. I told them not to wear heels, but they might wear heels. I don't know if they're gonna wear heels, but I hope they don't. And we also have to get more moss for that giant puppet.
Okay.
Okay, great. And also the floaties, we gotta move the floaties. There's a giant hippo floatie and then there's a flamingo floatie, and we have to move them away from the pond because it can't look like that. We have to have the ceremony there. So we have to move the floaties and mow the lawn and call your mom.
Okay.
Okay, great. And also there's one more thing. There's a thing about my cardboard cutout of me, and I want it to be by the driveway. We need to make some signs, babe. And you know what? You need to make me a protege of that cardboard thing.
You mean prototype?
That's what I said. Okay.
babe, aren't you excited? It's gonna be the wedding. I'm so excited. It's gonna be so great. Yes. Okay, let's hug, babe. Let's hug. Babe, you gotta learn how to hug, babe. Look, it's like this. Just come here. Come here. Oh, babe, you're so good at hugging. You're so good.
Thanks, babe.
Let's kiss. Mm-hmm. The end. And now, I want to say one more thing, and this I'm going to need Isaac and Marina to come up here for. I need them to come up here to be part of this brilliant thing I'm going to say to them. So come on up here, Isaac and Marina, to the bride and groom one more time. Give it up for these fine-looking people. They're very beautiful. We love them so much. And, Emily, Matt, can you?
Yeah.
is going to do 100 push-ups in 1 minute, which to me is an impossibility, but who said he could do it? So, on the count of three, we're going to start it off. I have a timer right here. This is for you, my friend. Hold on, let's get the timer out. I'm going to tell you when to stop. Start. All right, you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
On your marks. Get set. Go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
In 57 seconds, 57.37. It's good to be young, huh?
Yeah.
Great job, Tim. You get the rocket beat for that.